Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sneha Shetty, Clinical Director, Chief Fertility Specialist, Gynaecologist and Laparoscopic Surgeon here from Vriksh Fertility, HSR Layout, Bengaluru.
So assisted hatching, it is an advanced IVF laboratory procedure which we usually do if in case the embryos which are formed after an IVF procedure is done has harder outer shell which we call as the zona pellucida. So normally what happens in natural pregnancy, once a fertilization happens, egg and sperm meet, it goes and sits inside the uterus and the embryo will usually break out of this shell which is called the zona pellucida and gets attached to the uterus lining and the baby forms and develops and growth happens. In IVF, the advantage is that we can see how the embryos are. The eggs are retrieved, placed with the sperm. An embryo is formed and that embryo under examination sometimes will be very, very thick. In such conditions, it will not hatch out like how usually it has to happen. So in such conditions, we use certain specialized methods called assisted hatching techniques in order to help those embryos to hatch out in order to increase the success rate of IVF. So when is this assisted hatching procedure or technique used? For which couples do we normally recommend it? Number one, if in cases of advanced maternal age. Usually if the woman's age is more than 35 or 38 years of age, the zona pellucida, we have observed that it is very, very thick. In such cases, usually hatching doesn't happen. So then we use this procedure called assisted hatching, which may be through use of certain medias or by using certain laser shots and breaking that hard shell and then placing that good quality embryo into the uterus of the female partner. Second, we use it if at all a woman has very poor quality embryos and the zona is also not looking that healthy. Then we help them increase the chances of success in IVF. So that particular poor quality embryo also may hatch out and increase the chances of conception. So third is in cases wherein they had multiple failed IVF cycles in the past, in spite of transferring very good quality embryos. In such couples also, on the embryo, we usually use this assisted hatching and then we implant or we transfer the embryo in order to increase the success. So how is this assisted hatching usually done? The procedure usually involves three steps. Number one is embryo culture. After an IVF procedure, once the egg and sperm are placed together, these embryos are cultured for up to 5 to 6 days, resulting in a blastocyst embryo, at which point they are ready for transfer. If we have multiple embryos or if the hormonal levels have crossed a certain point or in certain conditions, we do not opt for fresh embryo transfer, then we freeze them. Otherwise, the fresh transfer of at least one or two embryos are done into your uterus lining, provided the lining and everything is good. Step number two is the assisted hatching procedure per se. In this procedure, a specialized laser or mechanical technique is used to create a small opening or a hole in the zona pellucida, which is the outer shell of the embryo. So this helps in hatching of the embryo outside this shell and implanting into the uterus lining. Step number three is the embryo transfer. After assisted hatching, the embryos which have undergone this assisted hatching procedure are loaded into a very thin catheter, and once your bladder is full, under ultrasound guidance, these embryos are placed into the uterus. So this procedure in total is called assisted hatching. What are the pros of this assisted hatching technique? So the advantages is that it definitely improves your implantation rate. That means the success rate in IVF is also taken a step forward, and we make sure that a successful, happy, healthy pregnancy outcome also happens. Number two, potential for advanced age women. Certain age-related barriers may be there which prevent implantation from happening, be it naturally or through IVF conception. These barriers, like having a thickened zona in advanced age women, this barrier is also broken with the help of assisted hatching techniques. What are the disadvantages or the cons of this assisted hatching? Number one, risk of damage to the embryos. if it is not performed by a specialist or a very experienced embryologist, or if it is done using improper techniques or not good instruments, definitely there is a chance of damage to the embryos. Number two, risk of monozygotic twins is a little bit higher. According to studies, this assisted hatching procedure has caused a little higher risk of having identical or monozygotic twins. But overall, the risk is relatively very, very low. Number three, limited evidence of efficacy. While still many of the IVF centers all across the world use this assisted hatching method whenever required, we still need a lot of data and lot of studies on it in order to prove that yes, it actually is effective and it causes a significant increase in the success rate. That data is still missing. So the decision to go ahead with assisted hatching or not is completely individualized. It is not that every couple who undergoes IVF or every couple who has some history has to undergo assisted hatching. A thorough discussion with your fertility specialist and embryologist will ensure that you are in safe hands, and they will guide you whether you require this particular procedure or not.